It's been said that we're a mixture of our parents, every trait coming directly from one of them as they define who we are. But what if I told you that that isn't exactly true? This is Myths You Still Believe, the series all about explaining the truth behind the most commonly believed myths. Today, we're putting the microscope on all things that we thought we knew about genetics and exposing the truth behind many common pieces of misinformation. So without further ado, here are 7 myths you still believe about genetics. Every person has different genes. We've all heard it before, ooh, they got good genes, or, oh, they got there from their mom, suggesting that that family has something different within their genetics that differs from others. Well, the truth is that we all have the same 20,000 protein coding gene set. It's only genetic variations within and around those genes that creates our individual differences. Sometimes it's just luck of the draw, which is why you'll often hear how beautiful people have won the genetic lottery. Now, it is possible for someone to be born without a specific gene, but that is extremely rare and it's called a genetic deletion event. Some traits skip a generation. Let's say your grandfather has a certain trait or disease that you have as well, but it seems to have skipped your parents. That kind of phenomenon has led to a widespread myth that some traits skip a generation. The truth is, while some diseases and traits appear to skip a generation, in actuality, there are absolutely none that do. The quote-unquote skip can actually be attributed to defective copies of genes within your grandfather matching with normal copies of genes in your grandmother, making your direct parent a carrier of the trait but not actually affected by it. But if your other parent has those defective genes, then you will have a high chance when born of being affected by that trait or disease. Tricky genes. Two relatives can be determined by physical features. If you've ever seen a daytime talk show about paternity, or a movie about a young woman coming face to face with her absent father for the first time, you've likely heard of this myth. The notion is that someone can recognize a relative solely based on a feature that they share. Eye color, hair color, or maybe even a facial twitch or allergy. Now, while some physical appearances do have a genetic basis, it's not something that is a definite giveaway. Take the eyes for example. You can be born with the same blue eyes your father has, but like many developing infants, your eye color can actually change in the first few months of your life, potentially leaving you with a pair of brown eyes that oddly resemble the mailman. Mama got some splaining to do. Two lefties make a lefty. Speaking of debunking myths involving physical similarities between parents and children, here's an interesting one for you. If your parents are both left-handed, then you'll be left-handed, right? Well, not necessarily. In fact, there's only a 1 in 4 chance of you being left-handed regardless of your parents. According to Dr. Chris McManus from the University College London, the concept of handedness is a common misconception. In a study involving 70,000 children, he concluded that if both parents are right-handed, there's a 9% chance that they will still have a left-handed child and a 19% chance if one of them is already a lefty. So, your parents being left-handed does increase your chances of being so too, but it does not definitely determine it. All genetic mutations are harmful. This myth says that all mutations in your genetic code are 100% bad for you. And while it's true that mutations gained from exposure to viruses, radiation, and certain chemicals can cause damage to your immune system, not to mention those inherited directly from your parents, few are actually harmful. In fact, many mutations can actually benefit you. Now, I'm not talking about the kind of X-Men style mutations that transforms you into a superhero, though in a way, mutations can make you a better than average human being. For instance, there are mutations that can make your body more resilient, increasing your ability to fight off disease or even make you immune to specific infections and viruses. Gene defects are caused by environmental factors. Popular science, dramatic TV shows, and movies tell us that defects or mutations in genes happen because of exposure to radioactive materials, chemicals, or because we're not taking care of our bodies enough. Ah, but this is yet another lie that we believe, mostly because of the media. Often, when we find out that there's a genetic disease in our family, we often start searching for environmental reasons that disease originally got there. Exposure to certain elements can damage our DNA, but this is very unlikely to create health issues we pass along to our offspring unless you're pregnant at the time of exposure. Generally, genetic diseases most often stem from random errors our cells experience while processing copying DNA. One family member cannot mean genetic disease. This myth may very well be the most surprising on the list, and yet, with a better understanding of how genetics work, can be the most obvious. It claims that if you have an illness that nobody else in your family tree has, it must mean that what you have is not hereditary and thus not genetically passed. But the truth is, even without a family history of your illness, it's very possible that that illness or disease laid dormant in your parents' genetic makeup. That is, of course, until it made an appearance in you. There have been many cases of two parents each harboring a single defective gene inside of them. When they procreate, their individual defective genes are both potentially passed to the child, creating a recessive disorder causing you to be sick with the genetic disease. And now, my friends, you're just a little bit smarter. Giddy up. My friends, if you enjoyed this, please give it a like, and be sure to push the links in the description of this video, which will subscribe you to this channel, as well as my vlog channel, so you never miss a video. Thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you soon. Peace.
Bye.